This is Friday, June 26, 2009, and this is your Daily Dose. All right, those of you who know, I am a licensed cannabis patient in the state of Nevada. I just wanted to go ahead and give you a little nice little fat nugget of some Grandaddy Grape. I'm not real good at holding it in front of this camera, so just want everybody to take a look at that. Thank God it's Friday. Thank God a fellow patient came by. A little bit of that for me. Not a ton. Those of you who know it, just so all those idiots that think they're going to come rob the office or whatever. We're not allowed to sell cannabis, but I'm allowed to possess it, so I have a couple grams with me that I just want to smell all day long. Because it's damn delicious. And it's my medicine. And it won't kill me. I can't overdose from it. I can try, but it won't work. Cannabis is medicine. And we need to spread the word. Those of you who are patients who have trouble accessing quality organic cannabis, by all means, come on down to the office. If you have your card and your signed attending physician statement from within the Nevada program, boom, we can talk. If you are not a patient and you want information about the program, we can talk. We're also going to be offering classes. I know we talked about that. I'm just now starting to get those motivated individuals who have gone out and gotten the proper licensing they need to be able to do business in the glorious state of Nevada. We're basically going to have people that are going to, they're going to understand electricity. They're going to understand how to purchase and set up grow equipment. They're going to understand what it takes to be able to obtain clones. Everything, all aspects of the medical marijuana program of the state of Nevada. That's what we're here to help with MCCNV. Now, I myself might not be able to help that, but the people that we know within the industry, that we all have our own little nicks. For example, mine is I have no problem talking to groups of people. I have no problem communicating to them what it takes to be in the program. Whereas other members within this community, we might have one person whose forte is growing, cultivating, producing their own quality medicine. Well, until we get the okay to be able to show people and legally train them how to do this, which gray areas in the law, you know, everybody can say what they know and what they don't know until you have attorneys and, you know, defendants and prosecutors in front of a judge that decide if the law is good or not, we won't know. So we're taking the time and doing everything we can, doing our due diligence to try to find out what we can and can't do. Every day we're learning more about what we can and can't do. And pretty soon, I can tell you this, we will be able to start doing those classes. Right now, I can offer classes. Basically, if you want to learn how to get into the medical marijuana program and you don't want to have your hand held through it, basically, I'm going to start doing info classes. I will start having groups of people in, or you can request my presence at your home. And for a certain fee, I will basically write you a checklist of everything you need to do to get into the medical marijuana program. That way, you don't have to come down to the office and worry that you're being photographed coming into the office. That way you don't have to worry about if little aliens are following us when we're going around getting you into the program. I mean, I get to hear all the stories. And I, you know what? Whatever you believe, I'm not here to change that. You can keep believing what you want to believe. But just know this. For every belief that you have, there is a lot more people that believe this. I went down to the office. The dude helped me get my card. I'm following the rules. I'm good to go as far as the state is concerned. If somebody comes in after the fact, hey, let's go to court. Let's see what the judge says. And let's keep arguing as a group and effectively attacking all the negative things that are holding back our medical marijuana program. That's the only way we can make change. I mean, you can yell and scream and just, woo, that's going to make people want to believe your cause. But if you effectively communicate to them what's wrong, why there's a problem, and then show them practical examples of where it's flawed, you have to train people why something's. You can't just say something's bad and, well, it's just bad because. No, son, you can't have that. That's bad. Well, why is it bad? Or why? Validate. Plain and simple. Because right now I can validate that I'm a licensed patient. And I can validate that I got a couple grams of some delicious Grandaddy grape right here. That's validatable. I can also validate that this saves me the need for lower tabs today and every other day. Not a knock against lower tabs, those work very effectively for some people in the treatment of pain. Unfortunately, it leads to a lot of side effects, constipation, internal bleeding, all kinds of crap. I'll stick to my cannabis. Continue to seek out information. Find other news sources. Go to other different states. Look what they're going through. Here in Nevada, we have a program, and people don't know about it. I get calls from all over the country every day. People that are in states that don't have programs that just wish. I've actually had two people move to this state and are going through the process of basically becoming residents, sold their home back on the East Coast, and have moved here and are getting residency strictly because they believe their opportunity to be able to use medical cannabis in the state is going to save their lives. They don't care that they left behind a $500,000 house. They don't care that they had to take, you know, a hit on it to be able to move. They cared about quality of life. And that's what this medical cannabis program for the patients in Nevada is all about. It's about us receiving the quality of life that we want, course of treatment that we want, with a doctor knowing that we're doing this and understanding why we're doing it and being able to counsel us along the way, as well as people like myself educating and informing. This is what we do. This is the Medical Cannabis Consultants in Nevada. Right now we're in an office off of Rainbow, Washington, but one day, we're going to have that big building with the big purple MCCNV up on top of it. We're going to have an elevator and a nice cherry desk. Probably not. I'll probably use something biodegradable like balsa wood to save some money and stuff. Try to be a little bit more fiscally responsible than some other organizations out there that we've seen in the news and stuff. The big thing is, and I can never say it enough, educating and informing people about, one, we do have a program here. Two, there's a lot more people that are eligible for it that have no idea, that just overanalyze. Paralysis through analysis. If you're sitting, well, what if this happened? Well, what if this happened? Well, what if pink elephants had green penises that could impregnate people like myself? What if ninjas ran the world? What if Transformers really did exist? What if AA batteries were called double Z batteries? You could play that what if crap all day long. It gets you nowhere except more stress and probably gets people thinking things that aren't necessarily true. I spend a lot of time with the individual clients that come into our office, usually unprogramming the stupid things that their friends and people around them have told them. That isn't even based on fact. They just shoot it out their ass because, well, I guess they wrote the laws in this state. If you don't know, ask somebody. When I don't know, I have a really easy time. This is what I tell people. I'm going to show you how it works. They ask you a question you don't know the answer to. You can either feed them some bullshit, or you can say, you know what? I don't have the answer to that question, but I'm going to go get it. And I'm going to get back to you as soon as possible with that answer. Now, I'm the son of a military kid, so I understand the importance of being able to be held accountable. So when I tell somebody, hey, I'm going to do my best to get on this, and I tell them, hey, you're in my mind, even though a day or two might go by, I promise you, my mind holds a lot of things it shouldn't. And if there's somebody in need of something, as a nurturer and as a caregiver and as a provider, trust me, it stays on my mind. I'm here to help. The Medical Cannabis Consultants in Nevada, we are here to help. We're going to continue to educate and inform, spread the word. If you have friends at radio stations, TV stations, newspapers, and they want a real interesting interview, tell them to come on down and interview us. I'd like to tell the people here in Las Vegas and the people in our state what's happening to our patients. Most people don't know. Let's get the word out there. Let's show them. Let's teach. Let's educate the public. This was Friday, the 26th, 2009, and this was your Daily Dose. Rest in peace, MJ and Ferret Fawcett.